This is targeted more towards newer players. If you're a more experienced player, well, maybe you'll get some hard facts out of this as well. Anyway, let's just dive right into it. So this is new to the store. You can either just pick up Genetor Dovid, which looks pretty cool. He's got a funny looking hat and some pretty solid facial hair. Unfortunately, this thing over here won't actually show up in your game. But yeah, it's a pretty cool looking avatar. It's kind of up to you if you find that aesthetically pleasing or not. But as far as the set goes, just taking a look at it, it contains some very reasonable cards and a good start. If you're a completely new player and just have absolutely nothing, getting these four seats just to start off and not having to craft them can be helpful. I'm sure you know the struggle by now of each uncommon just being very draining. So if you wanted to play like a Horu Soldier list, this would be a good start. I actually have a version of this deck I'll be putting live. It might come out before this video or after. But a lot of the cards in this deck are cards that I actually included in mine. Just as we're going through here, we'll take a look. Genetor Dovid is one of the most very solid soldier-based card. And it's very easy to build build a soldier deck around him. Basically go in and type soldier and find all of them. It would be nice if he himself was a soldier, but hey, you can't win them all. Being a 2-power 4-4 makes him solid. His downside is your opponent gets two 2-1s, and they come into play stunned. There's a very solid way of getting around this. I'm not sure why they didn't decide to include it. I'll pull that up after we go through some of the other cards. Some of the other things to look at from this faction that you want to take a look at. Shock troops can be a very, very insane weapon if you're able to pull off the ultimate. And this deck definitely, as is, seems geared towards allowing you to pull off that ultimate. So I could see this deck actually doing well in like the lower ladders. Potentially around like bronze and silver. You'd probably be able to climb out with this deck and pretty handily. Some obvious upgrades to make. Maveloft Huntress. I would definitely want four of these. Just one of the best soldiers in the game. Plunder is a very powerful mechanic. And being able to use and leverage your other soldier's stats is very great here. There's a lot of cards that care about having things being stunned. So we can actually use Maveloft Huntress to stun and exhaust our own units and trigger those effects. Fencing Master being a 3-power 5-6 most of the time in our deck is very solid. One card I would look to add that's not included here is Permafrost. I'll pull that up after the video. Seasoned Drillmaster is a pretty solid aggressive card. You know, 3-power and then basically getting a slow speed Finest Hour on top. Just as far as uncommons goes, pretty solid. Being able to kill stun units is great. Being a soldier itself is helpful. And then Daring Swordmaster has a ton of Amplify synergy. And this deck they gave us actually gives us a ton of like really cheap Amplify effects to leverage this Daring Swordmaster. So other than that, we can draw cards off of Amplifies. And Frostcrawl Rider, which I actually included in my like meta version of this deck, is for all intents and purposes a 4-power massive beater with 5-5 being the absolute minimum. But most likely he's going to be a 7-7 or a 9-9, or if you've got some significant presence, he'll be like a 13-13 or something. So highly recommend this card. It would be one of the ones I looked to craft more of from here. Other than that, I mean, the deck's pretty much ready to go. You get a few helpful rares that I would probably include in the deck. I'll go ahead and pull up the deck that I was playing. Just an example of where you might want to go from here. I'll include a link to this deck down below. But we're using tactical superiority is one of the other important cards you want to be looking to craft if you're playing a soldier deck. Killing every stunned enemy unit is very solid. Notice that it's only enemy units, so if we're using Maveloft Huntress to stun some of our guys, you don't have to worry about accidentally killing your own guys. If you're cool like me and you're playing Roshi the Entrancer, totally named after me on purpose. That's not true. You can also exhaust things that way, and then you can amplify each of your soldiers. So hopefully you're able to blow out these soldiers that maybe they got from your genitor and draw a bunch of cards on top of it. Very solid way of both ripping apart your opponent's board and filling our hand. Speaking of stunning, I know this card is a legendary, but if you want to play the soldier deck, this is a card you're going to want to look to get at least one of to put in the market. I prefer it to just have four of them because it was an effect I always wanted, and I wanted as much of it as I could get. So having this come into play and stunning the enemy's team, and then playing another on top of that and stunning their team again and just slamming in is an insane effect. Other cards I opted to play that are a little different. This card is a rare, but being able to silence your opponent's cards and having this be another 4-drop that can be a 4/4 or a 6/6 a good portion of the time was pretty solid. And I liked it just as much as Frostclaw Rider. Frostclaw Light Rider tends to be bigger most of the time, but having a silence effect on top of it. So I was kind of just playing a mix of both. Other than that, cards I was playing over it, you'll see that I don't have as much Amplify synergy in my version. I instead opted for more Plunder effects out of this Boulder Gate Guard. Daru Lee being another legendary, also a soldier, and having a very strong top-end Amplify effect. Early on in the game, you can use Daru to really just pop forward. So, don't want to go too in detail about this deck. I'll do it in another video. I just wanted to show an example of where you can go from here and where you can go from the theme deck. As far as I'm concerned, the theme deck is a very solid purchase. If you think soldiers might be a kind of deck you'd enjoy playing, I'd say it's worth it for you. Otherwise, it's easy to skip over this. It's definitely going to come down to your own opinion of if you want to play with these cards. I know we got given the Maveloft Huntress from other sources, so for you, it might just be dust, and you might consider not having this. But if you don't have Builder's Decree and you don't have Maveloft Huntress yet, it might be worth just picking this up just to have those cards and not to have to craft them. Thanks for watching. I'll be doing more reviews of this effect just to help out some of the newer players and give them some insight on what we think. What I think personally about these decks and if they're viable. I would say that on a scale of 1 to 10, this is probably a solid 8. And, if it's an 8, you're not going to be late when you're showing up on that date. I made that up on the spot and I know it was terrible. So I'll just end the video there. If you thought my joke was terrible, subscribe. If you thought my joke was awful, drop a like. And if you thought my joke was pretty trash, go ahead and comment about it down below. If you bought this bundle, let me know. I'll probably be buying it eventually. But that is all for this video, and thank you for watching.